Incumbent upon me to announce that chat and Q&A have been turned off for the meeting. This is to prevent any potential violations of the Brown Act and public comment outside of the time when public comment is open. I would like to start by welcoming our two new City of Sonoma commissioners, Commissioner Thomas Rouse and alternative Commissioner Donna Dombach. I would ask you guys if you wouldn't mind saying a thing or two about your experience in the Valley, and I guess I'll leave it at that. I'll let you choose, and we'll start with Commissioner Rouse, if you would.
Hi, Tom Rouse. I've been in the Valley for 30 years. I have served on the Sonoma City Council from 2010 2014. I served as the mayor for that my final year there. I've been involved in various nonprofits. I currently sit on the board at the Sonoma Valley Vintners and Growers Alliance, and I'm very happy to be here.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Hi, everyone. I'm Donna Dombach. I've been in the Valley since 2010. First in Glen Ellen, and then moved to the City of Sonoma. I am a newbie to government service, and I'm excited to start to contribute in any way that I can serve. But I have been involved in several nonprofits, both actively and contributing funds, such as Impact 100, Cancer Support Sonoma, Farm to Pantry, to name a few. And I'm excited to meet all of you over the next few months.
Wonderful. Welcome. I'd also like, at our last meeting, when Commissioner Ituri and Commissioner Chrysler had just joined us, we didn't really have much time. I'd ask them to also introduce themselves to the crowd, if you wouldn't mind. I'll start with Terry Chrysler, if you will.
Sure. Well, hi, everyone. I'm Terry Chrysler. I moved to Sonoma in 2011. I'm a realtor with Sotheby's, and I'm actively interested in participating in the community further and making a difference in whatever small way I can. My husband and I have a small wine brokerage and a small wine brand. So tonight's information doesn't pertain to me, but is of interest. But I am very much looking forward to helping to move the needle further for our community in a lot of different ways. Thank you.
Thank you. Commissioner Ituri.
Hi, everyone. So I worked for Sonoma Valley Unified for 25 years. I was the principal at El Verano Elementary School for 15 of those years. I'm currently the assistant superintendent of student services in Petaluma City Schools. I also am a founding member of Food for All. I'm the chair of the Springs Municipal Advisory Council, and then a few other things on the side. I also am a adjunct faculty at Sonoma State University. And my interest is building a bridge between the Springs and the city and working more collaboratively together. I'm a staunch advocate for the Latino community and are underserved. So, well, glad to be here. Thank you.
Welcome once again. Thank you for that. Let's see, at this point, I would move for a resolution to, if there are no suggested edits to the meeting minutes of the May 25th meeting, which we had. Does anybody have any suggested changes to those minutes? If not, can I get a motion from somebody to actually approve those?
I move for approval.
Thank you, Vice Chair Dickey. Anybody else for a second?
I'll second.
Thank you, Commissioner Pulvirenti. And all those in favor, raise hands or say aye. Aye. Anybody who objects, say nay or hands down. Seeing none, that pass, those pass. And now I would like to suggest that we have a motion on the minutes for the August 24th special joint meeting, which we had. Can I get a motion there? Commissioner Pulvirenti, I see you looking like you want to.
Yep, I'll make a motion that we approve those minutes from that meeting.
Thank you. Can I get a second?
I'll second.
Thank you very much. And all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Raise your hands, aye. Those opposed say nay or thumbs down. Seeing none, they pass. Now, at this point, we turn to item number 3 on our agenda, which is public comment. This is limited to items not appearing on the agenda. And the time limit for public comment will be 2 minutes. I would ask the public to use the raise hand function if they wish to speak. And call-in users can press *9 to raise their hand and *6 when you hear the prompt to unmute. So at this point, I'd like to invite anybody from the public to raise their hand.
I'm not seeing any hands, Chair Freeman.
Thank you, Ariel. And I'll give that 10 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. At this point, I will close the public comment section of the meeting and move to item number 4. Which is the countywide winery events ordinance. We are to receive this item tonight from our presenter, Brian O, who is with the county. It is an informational presentation on the countywide winery events ordinance. That's ORD 16-0001. The Sonoma County Board of Supervisors will hold the public hearing on November 1st, 2022 to consider adopting the winery events ordinance as recommended by the Planning Commission. The draft winery events ordinance includes countywide definitions and standards for winery visitor serving uses. The ordinance would apply to new and modified use permit applications for winery visitor serving uses in agricultural zoning districts outside of the coastal zone. And there have been materials that have been provided to everybody at this point. At this point, I would like to turn it over to Mr. O and listen intently.
All right. Thank you, Chair Freeman and members of the commission. Welcome to the new members as well. My name is Brian O. I'm the comprehensive planning manager for Permit Sonoma here with the County of Sonoma. And I am grateful for the opportunity just to provide a short informational item on just where we're at. Chair Freeman I don't know if I could top his summary there. That was quite concise and to the point, but I will add just a little bit of filler to it as we get ready to get in front of the board on November 1st. So I have a short presentation. Let me share my screen. Is everyone seeing my screen? All right. So the purpose of this evening is to provide a status update on the winery events ordinance. Again, we are getting to the board on November 1st of this year. And a lot has happened to get us to this point, dating back to 2014, when this effort was put into our Permit Sonoma work plan. There's been a number of meetings and discussions, studies that were done both with the Board of Supervisors and consultants to get us to this point. And really, we've been building off of the work that the working group back in 2015 had established to really chart our course. We had a number of report backs to the Board of Supervisors, and the culmination was a workshop in 2021 with the public to start a process to establish some standards and definitions on regulating winery events. And we've had four commission hearings on our draft ordinance. And so we kicked off that effort with the Planning Commission June 3rd of 2021. And ultimately we received a recommendation with modifications from the Planning Commission on June 7th of this year. And I just wanted to highlight, just because of the connection here with this commission, just how much the local guidelines had gone into the creation and the development of the countywide standards. So what you see are a pair of our local guidelines within unincorporated Sonoma County. And what we're bringing before the board for their consideration with the Planning Commission recommendations are definitions for a number of key issues defining winery events. So everything from defining a catering kitchen to an industry-wide event. There was a staff recommendation, draft ordinance that was released back in 2021, and through the deliberations with the Planning Commission, one additional definition. So that's the big change when we think about the definitions from what the staff had released over a year ago, was the Planning Commission recommendation to add a definition for wine tasting room. And all the details are in the packet that's part of the agenda. The other component to the ordinance are operating standards. So you see here everything from standards for winery events to wine tasting rooms, the size of events, the hours of operation, all the way out to outdoor burning. And so everything you see in the sort of the maroon text, again, were recommendations by the Planning Commission through extensive deliberation. And the actual, so the sort of official recommendation that we will be taking is to for the board to consider an amendment to our zoning code to add the aforementioned definitions and standards. And for those definitions and standards to apply to new and modified use permits, and also impacts in our three zoning districts identified here. And again, we are looking forward. We expect the staff report to be released in the first 2 weeks of October with plenty of time for public review of any of those changes and in time for us to get in front of the board on the 1st of November. And so that concludes my presentation.
Much, Brian. Appreciate that. at this point, we'll kind of follow our normal course here, which is to have the presentation and then questions by commissioners. I would turn to my fellow commissioners and raise your hand if you do have any questions for Brian about his presentation. Okay, well, I'm not seeing a flood of questions. I am seeing Vice Chair Dickey raise his hand. Vice Chair Dickey, if you'd like to ask your questions, please.
simple one question. I'm wondering if we're still going to be able to use the local area guidelines for CAC deliberations.
Through the chair, absolutely. I mean, I believe those are part of the CAC, if not the Blue Book, definitely something that the CAC had approved last year. And then we could, I think there's been a question just about how to communicate that and pair that with the board consideration for the countywide ordinance. And so we'll have, as part of our presentation, not just going into some of the history and background on the SVCAC guidelines, but also the ones for Dry Creek as well. And so that'll be part of the staff packet. I believe also Dry Creek had, and we're happy to facilitate this if there's interest from the CAC to work with our clerk to get sort of a communication from your commission up to the Board of Supervisors in some official capacity. But just that distinction and application, there's a really great chart that we'll point to just on future use permit processes. So someone comes in, an applicant comes in to permit Sonoma, where in that process will they have the guidelines in front of them as part of their working with the local community? And so that'll be highlighted in the staff presentation in November.
Ryan, just one follow-up question. You're codifying certain elements of this for planning purposes, obviously. We're an advisory body. In those areas where our local preferences are obviously different than than the county will have as their codified, deliberations. How often do you think the county is going to supersede our local advisory choices? I'm struggling for the right words here because I'm just not a planner any longer, or never was actually.
I count you as a planner. Vice Chair Dickey, whether you like it or not. So there's an important distinction there, right? This is an advisory commission. So when an applicant comes and presents a future project, the intent would be they have those guidelines in hand as they're forming their application and proposal. I would also urge the commission just, there was a lot of work that we extracted from the guidelines themselves that made it ultimately into the countywide ordinance. So there shouldn't be a whole lot of distinction. I mean, obviously it's not a one for one, but it absolutely part of the DNA of the countywide ordinance was influenced by the guidelines that this body had approved.
Thank you.
Well, I actually ex officio bar at his discussion. I'll come with you and others. Thanks,
Mr. Chairman. Brian, I just wondered if are you going to be asking the board to adopt the local area guidelines or bless them or direct any kind of review of consistency or anything like, I mean, is there going to be any official action from the board that recognizes the Dry Creek and the Sonoma Valley guidelines?
So one path, thank you, ex officio Carr. So through the chair, one path we can follow that has been done is Dry Creek had gotten in front of the Board of Supervisors. Again, that's something I'm happy to work with the clerk on facilitating, but that was a presentation that was done by the commission. Aside from part of my presentation or staff's presentation will include the history that this group and the ad hoc, all the work that they put into the guidelines. And so they're not going to be codified because they are guidelines, and we have one set. The board is very clear. We need one set of clear definitions and standards for the county. And so there will be a distinction, right, between the two.
That answers your question, Ms. Exposito-Carr. I'm presuming that the answer to that is yes. And I'd now turn to Commissioner Chrysler. You're next on my screen.
Chair Freeman, when you lean, what is that? Stage right, real left? That's when your voice, there you go.
Thank you. Commissioner Chrysler, you are next on my list.
Yeah, thank you very much. I have a question regarding some of the items on Exhibit B. And one of the ones that I noticed is that in Item D, winery trade partners and winery trade activities were fully redacted. What is the reason for that? I guess I'm asking Brian.
Yes, thank you, Commissioner. I just closed it out. So if I could just have a moment to see what you're referencing.
So it's Item D. It used to be 8. And it's under the definitions of, let's see, sorry, wine trade partners and wine trade activities were both redacted.
Through the chair, so when you say redacted, you mean they were recommended for removal?
Well, it looks like they've been redlined through those items.
Okay, thank you for the clarification. So that was, I was alluding to the number of Planning Commission public hearings. And so throughout that process, we essentially went line, or the commission went line for line to walk through each of the definitions. And so part of that process included editing, adding, and removing of proposed definitions and standards.
Have trade partners or trade events been added in elsewhere then? Or is this something that's, because I read through the entirety of Exhibit B and it's not in there anywhere else.
Okay, so I have it open now. Apologies, could you just reference the page number one more time?
Sure, of course. It is item D, and there's a redacted 8 and a redacted 11 that are below item 10 under terms and phrases. So it's the second page of Exhibit B.
Yeah, so part of, if you look on the first page of the memo from June 7th of 2022, table one has sort of the look, compare and contrast, where each of the commissioners or the commission took a straw vote for each of those. So I don't know exactly what went into that discussion, but I do see the straw vote for removal of defining, making a you know, explicit definition for that.
Okay, thank you.
Commissioner Ex Officio Cornwall.
I was just going to ask Brian if you could repeat what I didn't see the table that you referenced that shows sort of the sequence that a applicant would go through.
Certainly. So it wasn't in my slide. I'm just thinking about the staff presentation, and we've presented on it to Planning Commission. And so the when the applicant, just like any referral packet that this commission receives on land use items, that's what I was referencing. And so as part of that process, the commission now has a set of guidelines specific to the Sonoma Valley that would, I imagine, influence the discussions that the commission has with a future applicant.
Okay, I misunderstood. I thought you said it was in the packet, but okay, thanks.
CEO Carr. Officio Carr.
I thought I could help with Commissioner Chrysler's call. I sat on the commission for this item, and there really was not any significance to deleting those definitions. I think the commission just felt there were too many detailed definitions of many different business activities that are associated with wineries, and the definitions, it wasn't necessary to identify every specific activity. So it had nothing to do with whether or not those activities were allowed or not. It was simply whether a definition was needed for them that separated that activity from other of the business activities that wineries typically conduct. So I guess I would pitch that it was pretty much insignificant. It just over the course of time, a lot of definitions were added by the staff and by input through various parties, but the commission pretty much, we got rid of, I think, maybe 6 or 7 different definitions that we thought were an understood part of winery business activities.
Thank you for that clarification, Commissioner Carr. Do we have any other questions for Mr. O?
Mr. Chairman, could I just add one thing? I think it would be a good thing for someone on the commission to make a point of talking to Supervisor Gorin about the issue of the Sonoma Valley guidelines being on the board agenda that day, and whether or not it wouldn't be appropriate to have the board do the same thing it did for the Dry Creek guidelines a few years ago. And that is, I guess the best thing would be to say they recognize them or something of that nature. I don't remember what the exact language was. Brian's right, they're not gonna be codified. If they were to be codified, they would have to be modified to resolve the differences between your guidelines and the code. And I don't think that's the intent of the board, but I do think it would be worth having a resolution of the board that recognizes the Sonoma Valley guidelines, that at least gives you the cover of saying these have been viewed and accepted by the Board of Supervisors. I think that would be very important down the road.
I think that's great advice. Commissioner Dickey, didn't you work on those extensively?
Yes.
Sorry, I know you're not a planner. However,
language I became familiar with.
There we go. And are very good at actually enumerating when you're talking. So,
I don't know. Yes, I will. I'll reach out to Supervisor Gorin.
I think that's a great recommendation.
I agree. Totally appropriate. Yeah. Thanks, Greg.
Thank you. Do we have any other questions for Mr. O at this point? Seeing none, I would at this point turn to the public and ask them if any of them had any questions or comments that they'd like to make regarding this topic. Again, if you would raise your hand, we can move you to a speaker if you are so inclined. And 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Seeing none, I would then go back, and I think at this point, we're not doing a resolution. I believe everybody's questions have been answered. And Mr. O, do you have any parting things you'd like to tell us concerning such?
I do not. Thank you for the time.
Thank you for the presentation. We greatly appreciate it. So at this point, item number four, we are through with the countywide winery events ordinance, and I would move to a bit of a discussion surrounding our November and December SVCAC meetings. And I will at this point, as they say, throw it to Ariel to talk about.
Thanks, Chair Freeman. So as any of you serving on this commission for any length of time know, the fourth Wednesday date always runs into conflict with November and December holidays, and often the meetings need to be adjusted. So looking at the calendar this year, it looks to me like the December meeting's actually fine. It falls on the 28th. I know folks do go out of town. You know, that's okay as long as we have a quorum if we're gonna meet. But the November meeting would fall on the 23rd, which is the day before Thanksgiving. That's not a time that we wanna hold a meeting. I was recommending that we move it to the 30th. I also want to mention that one of our future agenda items is the Kenwood Ranch. We've been talking about its upcoming since April. I met with them today, and they would like to come before the commission, and they would like to come in November, and they would like it to be moved to the, I'm looking at a calendar over here, the 16th, so the week before Thanksgiving. You know, it's really up to you all. They are also requesting that it be a hybrid meeting, so it would be in person with a virtual option for the public. I'm happy to answer anyone's questions. That sort of lays it out there. And then again, we're looking for a resolution on what November date you would like, and that, you know, the December date is okay. Basically, it looks okay to me, but, you know, feel free to speak up. Your voice is disappearing again.
Vice Chair Dickey has a question.
Ariel, I think our MAC meetings are scheduled for instance, on the 16th. So that might be a conflict, or we could have a meeting for both. Is that what you're proposing?
So again, this is sort of something we need to discuss, and I just had this conversation with them today, like this afternoon. The times are different. The North Sonoma Valley meets at 5:30. The Kenwood Ranch might be something that the North Sonoma Valley body could be interested in. We could look at doing it as a joint meeting. That was originally why I was recommending the 30th, is because of the conflict with the North Sonoma Valley MAC. We could also do even earlier in November, say the 9th. We could also pick a different day of the week if we needed to, but I'm personally pretty comfortable with the Wednesdays. The 9th would conflict with the Springs MAC meeting, which would mean that Commissioner Itari wouldn't be able to be here. Although I do think that the Kenwood Ranch is probably less of a concern for folks in the Springs area than it is for folks in the Kenwood and Glen Ellen area. But that's something for us all to consider.
And is their presentation informational, or will it require a resolution?
It would be, an advisory, resolution. It is a design review, and it's just for the winery portion. But yes, it would be, they're going through the design review process. it's not quite ready for design review yet, and I'm sort of getting into future agenda items, but this is sort of tied together. They expressed to me today that they wanted to come before this commission earlier so that you all could, if you have notes, essentially, or wants that they could accommodate, and the public as well, that they would be able to accommodate those and roll them into their application.
Well, it seems like it'll be a long meeting. It'll be our first application of those CAC winery event guidelines that we just discussed. And with all the new members of the commission in the meantime, there's probably a kind of a learning curve to familiarity, I would think.
Well, and you have to, and it's going to be a struggle with that item, right? Because it is just design review, right? That is what it is. So it's about how the building looks. It's not about the use. This is an entitled project that's been entitled since 2007 or so. It's difficult to cleave apart because folks have very strong opinions about this project, but the fact is that it was entitled in the late 2000s before Supervisor Gorin was even elected. And, you know, so they're going before design review. Your advisory recommendation would be limited to design elements of the project, not the activities of the winery, just to clarify.
So how would we reach out to the North Sonoma Valley MAC to see if they'd be interested in having a dual meeting?
So if that is what is decided by this body tomorrow, I'll talk to Hannah, who staffs the North Sonoma Valley MAC. We have kind of enough lead time, right? So we're talking about November 16th. So we would, and then that would be brought to the chair and vice chair of the North Sonoma Valley MAC. That would be how. I think you could also make a sort of dual recommendation resolution today and say 16th or 30th, you know, however you guys want to do it. It's your decision what night to hold it on. I'm just full disclosure telling you the conversation I had today.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ariel. Commissioner Felder?
Yeah, I'd just like to point out that there's also a conflict on November 16th with the Sonoma City Council meeting. I'm not sure that we would have significant input to this item if that's the only item on the agenda, but it is a conflict, and so you would not have our representation.
Thank you for that, Commissioner Felder. Ex officio Cornwall.
I think it'd just be, people are really busy. And so it seems to me that combining with an Orson Levi Mac on this would save people some time and increase transparency around this big project. So to me, that sounds like a smart move.
Thank you for those thoughts. Does anybody else have any comments at this point? Oh. Commissioner Ituri.
Hi, thank you so much. So I hear you're combining with perhaps North Valley. I also would suggest it to include the Springs MAC as well, because we're small. It all affects us. So I think it would be important to include them in the conversation as well. Thank you.
Great, thank you. Other thoughts on this? I guess what I'm hearing at this point is there's conflict all around, but I think it sounds to me like the potential of doing the 16th and including in that the Springs MAC as well, asking them to participate in making it a three-way meeting might make sense. But it would conflict with the city of Sonoma, our representation there. Whereas the 30th, while not ideal for the candidate, the people presenting and their presentation, it might be a better one for all concerned. Because I haven't heard anything, and correct me if I'm wrong, I haven't heard anything that says that November 30th would be a challenge for any of us here at the moment. Okay.
I'm concerned about would we have a quorum if we're missing the Sonoma City Council members?
The Sonoma City Council members don't actually count towards the quorum. So the quorum is six voting members.
So although
we love them and their input, they don't count towards the quorum.
But also, so, I wasn't hearing that the 30th was a challenge for them. Correct me if I'm wrong. Okay. So that's where I'm leaning towards the 30th based on everything that I've heard, but I'm open to somebody saying the 16th is better and we unfortunately would lose our friends from the city. Commissioner Secretary Spaulding.
Thank you. Excuse me. I think it's a good idea to do it on the 30th. I'm very respectful of the time and effort that the presenters will go to, and we try to accommodate them, but their needs are not as great as ours. We're volunteers, they're getting paid for it. So I think the 30th is a good choice. Thank you.
Thank you for that wise statement. Commissioner Pulvarenti.
I would agree that November 30th is a good date. My question would be to the representatives of the two MACs. Could we still invite the MAC to come on the 30th? Because it seems like it would be really efficient for them to hear this presentation about this project rather than have to hear it later on from the applicant. I don't know. I'm looking for input from those two MACs, what they feel.
Thank you. So as far as the Springs MAC is concerned, would be two meetings for us that month. And it sounds like it would be two meetings for the North Valley MAC. So that seems equitable. And we'd be inviting them to this meeting. So I don't know that everyone would attend, but the invitation is important, I think.
I agree.
Yeah, the North Sonoma Valley MAC. Boy, is that a mouthful. I think we may even decide that we're just going to have a single meeting that month and make it for the 30th. I think that should be amongst the proposals amongst ourselves.
Great. So at this point, I am now clearly hearing, I believe, that November 30th with an invitation to both of the MACs to attend would be ideal for this body, and that we would certainly invite everybody to attend it and hope that that works for the applicant.
Can I ask one before you go to the motion? This doesn't have to be included in the motion, but their request for a hybrid meeting. I know the council chambers is where SBCAC traditionally met. I have checked out that space. It's not adequate for that amount. It's already challenging for the amount of folks that sit on SBCAC. And especially with the new sort of tech that they've put in there. So I think if we wanted to do hybrid, we would have to find an alternate venue, which is fine. I would just like to know if this body feels like that's worth exploring. And then I can work on that and let the applicants know. I know that they very much wanted it to be the 16th and they very much wanted it to be hybrid. And I said that I would say that to you all.
What's the reason for their hybrid meeting request? Do you know offhand?
Their perspective is that things are missed on Zoom. They feel that they communicate better, that communications with commissions and the public go better when they're in person. They also mentioned kind of liking the sort of informal after the meeting where folks could, you know, when the meeting gets out, folks could come up and chat with them and ask them questions because they seem very interested in interfacing with the community and hearing what folks have to say. So that's sort of their perspective.
Kind of a valuable insight, actually. especially given the nature of this project, you know. So maybe we could go down to Santa Clara and do it in the football stadium, huh? They have a jumbotron there.
There's no room for comedy in this.
No room for.
I would love a reason. Personally, I would love a reason for us all to be in one space again. I prefer in person myself, but at the same time, also understanding the limitations of the location that we use. I don't know. I'm feeling like November 30th is the date, and that it looks like invitations would be out to the many, and the challenge will be for the county to find a space for us to meet. Does that sound like what I'm hearing? Commissioner Spalding, Secretary Spalding, you're on mute. You're still on mute, Commissioner Spalding. You're back on, there we go.
Oh.
Okay.
I have the same sentiment about this venue issue as I had about the date. I don't really think it's up to the county to bend over backward to try to accommodate their desire. We've had a lot of presentations and quite in-depth and successful ones, I think, by Zoom. And I'm not sure that this entity should be given favorable treatment of any kind. They're kind of under a cloud already, honestly. And to ask the county to jump through hoops to accommodate their, so that they can make a more impressive presentation, excuse me, just sort of really rings wrong to me. We'd all love to be meeting again in person, except I don't like driving home afterward. That's it, thank you.
No, thank you for that thought. I hadn't anticipated that it was for them. It was more of a selfish comment on my part, and also thinking that an attempt would be made. However, if that attempt was not successful, it would turn into a hybrid meeting for the commissioners. Some commissioners wouldn't have to necessarily be in the space, but I leave it to Ariel comment at this point, because she looks like she has a thought that she wants to share.
Oh, and I know Commissioner Dombach, I'm sorry if I said that wrong, also wants to speak, but I just, having never run a hybrid meeting before, and if we're doing a joint meeting, then I will have the other staff there as well, which would be helpful, assuming that the North Sonoma Valley and Springs Mac want to do it. My personal preference is that if and when we do a hybrid meeting, whether it's this meeting or not, that the commissioners do not join virtually, that the commissioners all appear in person, and that the public participation option is for the public, and that the public can show up in person, or the public can connect via Zoom, just because as one human being, I'm not sure how to monitor someone on Zoom when everyone else is there and they want to speak, right? It's just, it's a logistical thing. And maybe once I got the hang of it, it would be different. But when I've seen true hybrid meetings work, where some folks on the commission are remote, there's at least three staff there to do that work.
I appreciate that comment. And so now it's starting to lean towards, at least in my eyes, this is helpful, that since we're trying to get all of our different groups together to view this, that having it be a combination makes no sense. And that doing it in our typical fashion, which is by Zoom right now, is probably the best treatment, because we don't want to show favoritism. But also because it's just a very practical issue. And we're, you know, trying to get everybody together to hear this together. And I think there's a very good reason to have all three groups together to listen to this, because I enjoy listening to the comments from not just this group, but also the others as well. And their perspective is certainly enlightening. So with that, I am going to turn to Commissioner Dombach and ask her what her question is.
Thank you. It's just an alternative thought. I mean, I do not disagree with how you're, with the conclusions that you're, that I think you're coming to with regard to making it virtual. But the only other thought I had, it may be naive, is whether the meeting could be held at the Kenwood Ranch and whether they have the facility to allow for a virtual Zoom.
Yeah. In this instance, one of the, just to that point, amongst the executive group, we had a message earlier today, and I had mentioned that I thought that this particular topic required a site visit, but that is usually handled outside of the presentation and, you know, with a limited number of commissioners there at any given time, and we would manage that within the Brown Act concerns that might be there. But just trying to say, I think not having it at their location would be wise, just based on all the, I'll say Michigas, but everything attached to that. But Commissioner Ituri.
Thank you so much. So I think a couple of things that I've heard, I really think that we need to stick to what we normally do and not turn this into something that is accommodating to someone who is asking something of us, I guess, is what I'm basically saying, because we all three bodies operate on Zoom currently, and it is what we're doing. And although an in-person meeting would be lovely, there's not a space to accommodate us and that amount of people. And then I think, and although it'd be lovely to see the site, I think it would bias us too much to walk into that space. So I'm suggesting that we stay in a Zoom setting for all the reasons stated thus far. So thank you.
Thank you for that. Commissioner Rouse.
And I would concur with that. We should not be making any special plans for them. We should be, if we meet via Zoom, we meet via Zoom. If we choose to have the date be the 30th of November, it's the 30th of November. This is not about them. Anything that we do to accommodate them will not look good for us. And I believe it's more important that we just continue. I would love one day to not have to do this on Zoom, but if that's the way we're doing it, I think we do it until we don't do it, and then we'll start to have in person and not say, yes, we'll do it for you, but we can't do it for you.
Great. And I'm seeing a lot of heads shake up and down, yes. And I just want to say that I still believe that we have a site visit there that people are invited to prior to the meeting, which I don't think is anything that anybody has issue with, but that we do indeed do it by Zoom. And I think that that's the wise choice here. And I do believe that I see a preponderance of votes for November 30th with an invitation to our fellow MACs. And we leave it at that. So with that said, we need a resolution on this. So if anybody would like to step up to the plate and put forth a resolution of what we have kind of communicated here, realizing that we are also talking about within this resolution, the regular December meeting would occur on 12/28. I would appreciate it if somebody put that forward. Commissioner Dickey.
I propose we have our regularly scheduled meeting in November on 11/30, our regularly scheduled meeting in December on 12/28, and in both cases they be Zoom meetings.
Very good. Do I have a second on that? Commissioner Rouse? You second it? Thank you. All in favor, say aye or raise your hand.
Aye.
Those opposed or saying no, say nay, or put your thumbs down. Okay, looks like we have a vote that says we will have the meeting on November 30th, and Ariel, I believe you will make the invitations accordingly.
Yep, I can take care of the rest. Thank you. Thank you so much.
No, thank you. We appreciate it. Now, at this point, we move from item number 5 down to item number 6, which is reports from our MAC liaisons. And at this point, I think I would turn to our North Valley MAC representative, which is Commissioner Dickey.
Anybody tired of hearing my voice yet? Our most recent meeting was related to SDC. We have composed a DEIR response letter, and that's been forwarded under the North Sonoma Valley MAC letterhead to the Permit Sonoma.
Very good. I presume the whole meeting was regarding that.
Well, enough of it.
Okay, thank you. Appreciate that update. And now I would turn to our Springs MAC liaison, Commissioner Ituri.
Hi, everyone. So we had a refresher on the Brown Act because we have a lot of questions about social media and what we were doing and how we were posting. And we got a lesson in that we can't like each other's posts that have things to do with our work in the Springs MAC. So we got a whole lesson on that. We have to change our Facebook page to, it can no longer be a group. It has to be a public page. So we have a couple of things we have to do to clean up. We also spoke about the draft EIR, and we added an addendum to our first letter. Although we don't have a stake in the number of units in the in SDC, that's not really our concern. Although we are supportive of our North Valley MAC friends, we want 75% of it affordable. We know we're dreaming, but you got to dream big. So that was our addendum to the letter we originally wrote. Also, we had a lot of conversation about our projects and promotional materials because we are now doing a lot more outreach. We've been at the health fair. We've been at the emergency preparedness event. We did a creek cleanup. So we're working to polish up our image a little bit. And then we had a conversation about pavement work, which is super exciting because we're trying to find roads we need to fix. So that was the extent of our conversation a couple of weeks ago. Thank you.
Thank you. And I would say that's extensive, amazing. That feels like a lot of work. So thank you for that. Greatly appreciate it. So I think at this point, I would say that we turn to consideration of future agenda items. And at this point, I think I would turn to Ariel, if she would give us an update or ask any of the commissioners, which I see Commissioner Cornwall's hand up. Do you mind me turning to her first? Okay, Commissioner Cornwall.
I might have just missed this, or maybe I'm just confused about it, but the topic we just had today was informational, but it is going to the supervisors. So I'm not clear whether we, this body, wants to do or say anything about it before it hits its next.
If I will try to remember, please, executive team, hold me accountable, because I know Brian said that they're going to put out the staff report in early October. So if you don't hear from me, I'm going to send the staff report, since you received this informational item, to this body. You can also find it on the internet, but I'll make it easy and send it to you all. Since this is a countywide and not a district specific item, it's not something that came before this commission. You all had the areas of concentration guidelines, which were passed. So, generally, countywide things don't come before this commission. They go straight to the Planning Commission, which has representatives from all 5 districts, right? RHNA, the housing element update, You all received an informational presentation on that, like a year and a half ago now. That's kind of it, because, you know, they get your input, but it's a countywide policy. So that's how those generally work.
Although I will note that we are going to be having Commissioner Dickey speaking to the commissioner to recognize our guidelines for the Valley specifically. Correct.
And I'll work with, you know, I think it was Secretary Spaulding and Matt Dickey, Vice Chair Dickey, and Greg Carr, who were the Greg Carr was advising it, who were the winery event ad hoc. So I'll work with them to figure out, you know, if we, how we want to do this. I want to do what Dry Creek did. So I'm going to go and look at what that was. Was that a consent item and they spoke at public comment? Was it a consent item that got pulled off and then they were able to speak? I think that's the smart thing to do, is to just mirror however that worked for them. So I'll work on that, and I'll work with the ad hoc, and I'll loop in Supervisor Gorin, and we can make that happen. That's not a problem.
Thank you. Appreciate that all the way around. So thank
Does
you.
That answer your question, Commissioner Cornwall? So as far as future agenda items, we spent an extensive amount of time talking about the Kenwood Ranch Winery project. So the other thing we have on deck is there is a solar project. I always do this at the meetings and I forget exactly what road it's on, but it's a solar project. That one's not ready yet. So I will continue to pester the planner. And then of course, we are, I believe, still on track to hear the SDC a final EIR and specific plan at our October 26th meeting. Am I looking at that right? Yes, the 26th. So so far the schedule on that, the last I heard, and please correct me, Commissioner Carr, if I say any of these dates wrong, is that the final EIR and specific plan are supposed to come out on October 17th. And at this point, the final is supposed to go to the Planning Commission on October 27th. Your regular meeting is October 26th, which is one night before the Planning Commission. I have talked to Brian about this extensively starting back in August, because it gives me a little bit of anxiety that, you know, this commission makes recommendations to the Planning Commission, and there's literally less than a 24-hour turnaround before the Planning Commission meeting. He has assured me that they will represent, you know, because the minutes won't be out, right? That there's no way Lynn Murray can do that. That they will, you know, bring forward the discussion that happened here. So that is, as of now, that's what that looks like. Yes, Commissioner Aituri.
So I won't be here on the 26th, so there won't be representation from the Springs MAC. I just want to say that publicly. So I'm going to be gone for a few days. So should I send an alternate?
I don't know that we can do that. Although anyone from the Springs MAC is welcome to attend in the
public
and attend in the public. Yes. And, you know, as we get closer to that meeting, obviously, we notice our meetings 2 weeks ahead of time, right? That's our practice to make sure we try to hit the Kenwood Press and the IT, who don't publish regularly. I'm certainly, and I've talked to Brian about this briefly, if either of the MACs want to attend and also, you know, have sort of a speaking role, like be panelists alongside the presentation we get from Brian, if that's something they want to do, I'm certainly open to adding that to the agenda. So, you know, I'll communicate that with the staff for both MACs. I don't think we have a mechanism to send alternates to SVCAC.
Cornwall, you have your hand up.
Sorry.
Oh, you're good. All right. So at this point, do we have any more questions about future agenda items, or is there anything that anybody at this point would like to see included
that we don't have, we've also included items during this part of the conversation for anything that somebody would like to see in the future, like a discussion about our Brown Act behavior, although I haven't seen anything that's made me suspect. So, okay, so that's item number 7. There's one item here that's looming large, and I'd like to see a motion from somebody. Item number 8, which is adjourn. Do I have a motion? I have Commissioner Pulvirenti.
I actually have a comment that have to do with future meetings, but I know that you all remember that we unanimously approved a 92-unit affordable senior housing project on Siesta Way. And I just wanted you to know, I took a drive by the other day and it's moving very quickly, which really shocked me because most of our projects seem to take so long, but this building is going up. So if any of you are down that way and you want to take a peek before they close it. So I just want to make that comment.
Thank you, Commissioner Pulvirenti. I have noticed that several times.
Yeah.
Okay. Would you like to now make a motion?
I will make a motion that we adjourn our meeting tonight.
Thank you. Do I have a second?
I second.
Commissioner Chrysler, thank you very much. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Thank you. Thank you all for your commitment. Greatly appreciate it. Look forward to seeing you in October. Cheers. Bye-bye.